growing up as a Roman Catholic in New Jersey, I had only ever seen Mass in English. I'd only ever seen the Roman Mass in English. I'm not even sure I would have been able to identify it as Latin Rite or Roman Rite or anything. It was just the Mass. But as I got older, I had other experiences. I attended the Novus Ordo Mass in Latin. I eventually attended the Tridentine Mass or the Extraordinary Form in Latin. And I came to realize that, you know, my own, the liturgical heritage of the church was broader. Later still, I went to an institute where there were many students from Eastern Europe, and we had, almost daily, we had the Byzantine Divine Liturgy of St. John Chrysostom. And as I began attending that and finding out how very different it was, I also fell in love with the Byzantine liturgy. And I recognized, I understood finally what John Paul II meant when he said that the church should breathe with both lungs, with the Eastern lung and with the Western lung. As different as the Byzantine liturgy is, it also taught me on a deep level what's common to all traditional Christian liturgies. It taught me that the adoration of the Most Holy Trinity is common to them. Pleading for the Lord's mercy is common. Begging for particular requests from the Lord, and of course, thanksgiving and praise. And so the Byzantine liturgy actually opened my eyes to the Roman or Latin liturgy in a way that nothing else could have done. And for that reason, I often tell my students that they should go out of their way to attend the Divine Liturgy of St. John Chrysostom or some other Eastern liturgy, because it will actually help them to have a deeper relationship with Christ and with the liturgy.